All right, you already know what it is. It's three!
Brothers and sisters! Brothers and sisters! I don't know what this world is coming to!
Yours truly, what's going on, good people? This is yours truly, Easy Deezy. This is episode 8 of Chop Shop. First of all, I want to make sure everybody made it safe and sound through Hurricane Ian. Those that were impacted and affected by that, prayers to you. I saw some people today actually going down to Fort Myers to get down there and try to, you know, get that going. So I want to thank those that are doing their part. Also, as you know, we always do every week, and every show is dedicated to the my man Will D's been gone with us for almost, say, 2 months now, man. So rest on, brother. We're going to keep the vibe going for you. As normal, I got to my right the infamous David Ruff and Greg Doss. How you feeling tonight?
I was feeling pretty good when you called and woke me up and told me we was going to do this show today.
Okay, good stuff. And speaking of, as you know, Doss let anybody know he went to Jefferson. So with that being said, We got royalty here tonight. We got Hillsborough County royalty here tonight. I mean, anybody that's followed basketball, I told y'all I had a surprise guest, and I got confirmation that I got a surprise guest in here. So I'm gonna get my man Tail here. You know, Tay Bryant, always family. That's my young wolf, my young bull. He do his thing. Green Bay won last week, so I know he got his chest stuck out. He feeling pretty good, and they beat the Bucks. That's another conversation.
3-1.
Okay, but the other special guest, Hillsborough County, elite basketball player, played in the NBA, played college ball in South Carolina, played overseas. Jefferson High School's own Terrence Kinsey, man. Welcome to the show, TK.
University of Thomas Jefferson High School. My very own, the university, 441 Cypress Street.
So, sir, there's going to be some foolishness tonight.
And also, I don't understand why you don't understand these things.
Oh, no.
Okay.
How you doing, sir? My apologies, TK. Everybody don't know.
Man, it's a pleasure to have me, man. It's an honor.
Okay.
Jefferson University.
All right. And also, we got via satellite outside of Tom Brady's summer home. One and only day, city stand up. Walt Dizzle, what's happening with you, baby?
Hey, what's going on, baby? Hey, we in the building. Hey, we in the building tonight, man. Hey. We down and out, bro, but hey, it's gonna be all right. We got an easy win coming Sunday, man. Let's go, man.
Hey, watch your mouth now. I told you we had detailed conversation. Don't get that started. Now I would have had certain best up the plug and take you off. Cut your volume down.
Yeah, it's gonna be brutal.
Hey, but tonight, man, we got TK and Tay and kicking it with us tonight, man. And Tay, I'll let you and TK let everybody know what y'all got going on. Y'all got a coaches convention coming up. I know Waldo shot ball back in the day at Ward for Coach Tadelli.
At practice?
No. Hey, Waldo had a fire. Tell about the soccer socks, Waldo.
Hey, that's a long story, man. That's a long story. We ain't got time. We ain't got time for all that, man.
Okay, well let's move forward. Let's crack up and get into it. Let everybody know what y'all got coming up in a couple of weeks, man, for the city.
Yeah, man. Once again, thank y'all for having me.
No doubt.
What we have for the city is a Hillsborough County Coaching Clinic. Why is that important? From our understanding, I believe about a month ago, they actually did have a coaching clinic that
Like two weeks ago
that we really weren't aware of. Like
okay,
I think who did that?
FBAAC.
Was it All Peoples?
No. That was a showcase. That was
okay. Like, my bad.
They had
okay.
it at Carrollwood Day.
Okay.
Yeah. So
we weren't aware of it at the time.
Okay. Yeah, we weren't definitely wasn't aware of it. So we wanted to put this together just to show the importance of, as we try to improve our kids and get them to the next level, what are we doing for our coaches to help our coaches get our kids to the next level? So that's the importance of having a coaching clinic to pretty much help them be able to understand their role, responsibilities, get them to the point where they know how to do a come up with game plans, practice plans, understand the philosophies and things like that. So that's what we're working on.
Okay.
Hold on. Now, do coaches have a referees have mandatory clinics they have to attend? And back in the day, Coach Hill, Coach Nellis before his time, but they told me they went to clinics with the University of Miami, which is what elevated the Jefferson passing scheme.
Okay.
They don't have these same things that are mandatory for either clinics that are.
No, they do not have.
I'm talking about high school coaches.
No, it's not mandatory, and that's what we're trying to do. To be honest, I'm trying to make that, because when you look at it, when we were talking about this, you have to have a degree to be a PE coach. Right?
Yeah. Right.
No disrespect. But now when it comes to coaching, getting kids to get to the next level, you just have to volunteer. Fill out an application of volunteering and say, I can be a coach, and volunteer your time.
Okay.
So, volunteering your time, and when you compare time with the salary, making $1,200, $1,500 a year, that's really volunteering your time.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Right. So with that being said, it's like, okay, if your coach is volunteering, is your coach really a professional in this field, or is he a no disrespect to the other professions, you could be a real life teacher as a social math teacher, scientist, you name it, librarian, and now I'm going from that and try to get these kids without no knowledge to the next level. Right. That's impossible.
I agree. I think something else with that is that, like we just spoke about, you talked off camera, the involvement of high school basketball in the area is bad.
Mm-hmm.
And I just, as far as, say, going to games, like I told you, I saw you play, because you played under my homeboy Coach Wash. Shout out to my boy Two Boy.
Shout him out.
I saw John Henson on a Saturday at Tech, and there was only one side of the gym bleachers that were pulled out. I've gone to district championship games, and there's only one side of the bleachers, and that's inexcusable. Crazy.
It's like that for real?
Yeah. Oh, well,
I went to a couple of tournaments. My daughter was at Berkeley. And I know I went to see them play. I forgot who was at Tampa Prep at the time. But you're right. I didn't have any. And that was only because there's multiple teams there. And even that wasn't sold out, which was surprising to me.
Right.
I thought it'd been standing room only. But I would think you have more love for high school basketball in this area.
When we bring. Like, I know Berkeley used to do, like, the little Geico Challenge at there when they bring teams from out of state. Or, like, I think they brought AZ Compass 1 year, Mount Verd.
Yeah.
That's when Ben Simmons and D'Angelo Russell was playing.
I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you about Ben Simmons. Bring Waldo up for this. Waldo called me. Waldo went to the they played Tampa Prep.
Ben Simmons, my homeboy.
Yeah, that's a long way. That's a long story. Anyway, Waldo called me outside the park, and I said, man, I just saw the best high school basketball player ever. He said, this is when Juwan was at Prep. And he's like, man, like he dunked him like it's like your uncle playing like with his little nephew. Like he scored 30, like didn't even break a sweat. You know?
Wow,
yeah.
And he was hitting threes too. He was shooting that bit too. Now y'all ease up on Ben, man. He was shooting that bit
closer. That's why,
right? And I think that's what I'm saying. Like, you know, when Waldo's at Warden, they had a following. You at Jefferson, you had a y'all had a following. And I think that's the thing. Like Dre, they went to Blake, saw them play King, but it's just like nowadays. Like let's just look at like when the schedule comes out, Warden's gonna be good. Sumner's going to be good. But let's say, okay, hey, let's say if Warden play, let's say just Chamberlain. Are people trying to leave, get there early? There are no games that people really get up for now, unless it's TC Jesuit. Especially the one at Jesuit is crazy. Then the one at TC is a good crowd.
Jesuit got the best, in my opinion, Jesuit got the best student session.
Yeah, they do that. They get into it. And I think the frustration is that,
but there's real tradition.
There's real tradition that goes with it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But Jefferson went to the 4-15.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like within 2 years, ain't nobody going to their games no more. And that's frustrating for me, because when you have a population of kids, and 5 years ago, Jefferson had 1,900 kids. You stay after school. Okay, the games be a little late. You stay at school and go watch your team play.
Right.
They just don't do that now. And I'm thinking what y'all going to do is going to be huge, because it covers so many different facets. Just like we spoke about the culture of high school basketball in Hillsborough County. Something has to change. And I'm hoping what y'all come in with is definitely going to do that.
Most definitely. We're going to have a – our camp is going to be a two-part camp. It's going to be first part of it. It's going to be strictly for the coaches to help them improve with whatever they need to know, learn. And then that second part is going to be strictly for the kids, for the student athletes, boys and girls, and the parents. We're going to talk to them on the realness of being a professional, being a student athlete, what actually you have to do to put in to making it. And also we're going to put some onus on the parents. Meaning, what are you doing? What are you doing to help get your kids to the next level?
Okay.
Reason being is because of, all this came about is because of my grandfather was my advocate. Like, I would not even be in this situation. Y'all wouldn't be saluting me if it wasn't for my grandfather.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Keep it 1,000.
Okay.
Just to share the quick story on a fast forward tip, I mentioned to you, I did not have one Division I scholarship coming on my last day of basketball. Last day of the season, I didn't have one D1 scholarship. Not one. I was in my computer design class, my favorite class, and over the intercom, they made an announcement said Torrence Kinsey won the 4A player of the 4A player of the year. I had no idea what that was.
Okay.
I didn't even care at that time because none of the accolades that I have won transitioned into getting a scholarship.
Okay.
So I was like, okay, bet. So my teacher, she came up, she was smiling and everything like that. The next thing you know, my principal and the coach come in, and the guy that was going to present that award. And the coach was like, Torrence, this is a big deal. I mean, you're the best player in 4A. You're the best player in Florida in 4A. So I called my grandfather, just to let him know what that meant. I asked the coach, let me use your phone real quick. Called my grandfather. My grandfather's exact words after I told him, I said, Grandpa, I just won the 4A player of the year. He said, are you fucking kidding me? And hung up. That was exact words. So I'm in front of the class. Seriously. So everybody looking to wait for my response. They're like, what did he say? I said, he said, are you fucking kidding me? And hung up. So I go back and sit down like it ain't nothing. 2 minutes later, coach come back in and with the phones of my grandfather. My grandfather hung up the phone and made a phone call to the North versus South All-Star game. That's All-Star game is for the best players in Florida.
Right.
So he asked them why my grandson wasn't. I'm tired of my grandson being overlooked. He don't have a D1 scholarship. He's not in this All-Star game when he just won the 4A player of the year. They said, Torrence. They said, Mr. Kinsey, we are so sorry that we overlooked your grandson. Bring him down here tonight. The All-Star game was that night.
Where was it?
Orlando. Okay, it was Orlando.
Okay.
It was in Orlando. So before this, we were talking about the All-Star game in Hillsborough County.
UNCF. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So we were talking about this all day.
Right.
And they're expecting me to play them. What you going to do? I'm telling everybody.
And the game's at Jefferson, right?
It was at Jefferson.
Perfect, okay.
That same day. So
exactly.
They looking for me to play. I skipped that game and go to the North versus South All-Star game.
They told
my grandfather, they say, we don't have a jersey for him. We're going to just bring him down here. We're going to put some tape on his back to give him a number, and we just put him in. On my way down there, my grandfather said, you heard what they said, right? That they ain't have a name, a jersey for you. He said, don't go down here and be playing like this no regular All-Star game. You don't got no scholarships right now.
Right.
He said, no, in order for you. He said, you need to go down there and get you a scholarship. At the end of that game, I won MVP. I snapped. You hear me?
Good stuff.
Everything I love.
Good stuff.
So I snapped. You hear me?
Dragon.
So that's how South Carolina come into play then?
Man, that's how South Carolina come into play. Because after that game, the gym was right around the corner trying to talk to my coach Grassoff. You can ask him.
No, I believe.
So the very next morning, we were getting ready to go to school. I mean, go back to school. I'm talking about 6 o'clock in the morning. Dang, he echoed out there.
Yeah.
That's how it sounded. That's exactly how it sounded. It was Seth Greenberg yelling, Torrence Kinsey. My grandmother's like, it's a guy yelling Lil T's name. My granddaddy said, who is that? My grandma go check the door. She said, it's a Seth Greenberg. He come in yelling, Torrence, great game. Mr. Kinsey, where are you? Great game. You want to offer him a scholarship right now. He has to take it right now. If not, we're going to give it to Sam Barber the second. That's who ended up going to USF, but
okay.
He was on the opposite team.
Okay.
Shout out to Sam. I love him.
Ate him up.
I ain't going to lie to you. Ate him up.
You put him on the stove. Yeah, you ate 1-3, man. Stand up.
Had to. So my grandfather looked at him. He was like, man, if you don't get the fuck out of my house. I'm sorry for cussing on your broadcast.
Yeah.
He's like, this is what he said. If you don't get the out of my house. Just like that. I'm talking about Seth Greenberg. He was like, Mr. Kinsey, what's the problem? He said, we trying to give him a scholarship. He said that USF would be the last person he would go. Matter of fact, he would not even go there if that was the only place he would go. He said he had, as a freshman, we've been there. Sophomore, we've been there. Junior, we've been there. Senior, we've been there. I'm talking about all these tournaments we had at USF. Y'all have not sent one person to come watch a game or even
really
Not even an interest level.
Nothing. So my grandfather said, man, if you don't get out of here right now, and he stopped on trying to talk. So my grandfather grabbed a phone book and threw it at him. And that's when he left. He said, you're not going to USA. So I'm looking at my grandfather like, man, that was my opportunity, to go to USA.
But your grandfather saw something greater.
He saw something greater. He knew something that I didn't know because that's, phone calls was coming in left and right. But right. He just like, you're not going to go to USF just because of that. But that's how I got to University of South Carolina. Because later on that day, Coach Duckett and Coach Odom was at the house from University of South Carolina.
Dave Odom, yeah, Coach at Wake Forest, Coach Tim Duncan.
Yeah.
So we're gonna get back into this TK story. Because I'm going to ask you some more about,
what year are we talking about?
02.
02.
Another thing to add on that. Nothing's changed with USF. They're still.
But like you said, it's funny you say that because, I mean, I want to pose that.
I'm trying to think who else is on that team because I can't.
What? USF?
It was Terrence Leathers on that team.
Terrence Leathers, yeah, I'm thinking in my mind, like, go ahead. So what, Waldo?
Well, BB was on that team too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, BB Waldo was on that, yeah.
Okay. Altron.
Altron Jackson, yeah, from Sarasota. Yep. Yeah. So. We're going to get back into it, Waldo. Hang with us, man. We're going to take a quick break. As I always say, man, shout out to one of my sponsors, Will D, man, Cigar Life, CIGARLYFE.com. Even though you ain't with us, man, we're going to keep this thing going for you. And Mr. Ruff, let everybody know what you got going on, man, to my immediate right. Let the people know.
What's going on? I'm a little stunned because I'm thinking about that year now. But Greg Dawson, GD, non-attorney pro se consultants. We help people navigate the court systems without giving you legal advice. And interestingly enough, one of the reasons I was sleeping because I had been working on an appeal in the second DCA. And I have a couple of other. If you get a chance to go to my YouTube page, go there. I'm going to start putting back up some interesting videos because we have a couple of situations going on in Hillsborough County that I've discovered regarding some jurisdictional issues that should have been discovered years ago for any of the guys who may have had issues with the Department of Revenue. So I don't want to stir up anything with your female listeners, not that I care. But the reality of it is that these are some significant jurisdictional overlooks. So some guys may have been subjected to child support cases where the court didn't have jurisdiction. I only know that because that was one of the issues that I had. And also I did complete my case management conference for one of my federal cases today.
You got the website and you got receipts? Oh,
we definitely show receipts, so I'm not one of these people that you may. I'm not a gimmick. And also, don't call me thinking I'm a gimmick. That's from Heavy, because he said people don't understand. I'm sorry I don't wear a suit every day. But not a gimmick. It's hard work, but we can definitely help people out.
Awesome.
So GreatDawson.com.
There you go. So me, Tay Waldo, and Team Jefferson, we'll be back in a couple of minutes.
University.
Serge, give us a little something. Give us a 2-minute break. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. So we finna get back into this thing. Turn my hat back up, man. I'm hanging out with my man Ruff, my man Tay. We got Dave City via satellite. Oh, okay. And we got my man TK here kicking it with us. I want to get back to that, like I say, with the information as far as I say with Seth Greenberg. So when South Carolina came into play, did you take a visit, conversation, or just what happened?
Actually, South Carolina was my third visit. Okay. I went from, after that Seth Greenberg situation, UMass, Boston College, then the University of South Carolina. I went to those two visits, then I went to South Carolina.
Had to be Bruiser Flint.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Calipari left. He left with Camby. He left after Camby.
Yeah, he left with Camby.
Like 99. What? No, I think Camby was 97. He was actually the second pit behind Duncan.
Yeah. That was like 98.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you went to UMass. You made a visit.
I went to visit the UMass. It was, I ain't gonna lie to you, it was great. Boston College was real good. Just a little gloomy when I went. You know what I'm saying? It's too cold.
It's Boston.
You know what I'm saying?
That's always like that.
And University of South Carolina, shout out to Carlos Powell. I ain't even going to lie to you. Hey, that was the best host. You know what I'm saying? How your college host, man, he showed me a good time. And it was like, this is where I want to be. Okay. And then also they offered the best graduation plan.
Okay. So let me ask you this. So going to South Carolina, that's SEC. And, I mean, they were new. They've been in the conference about 4 or 5 years. Because I know they went 1 year, they won the SEC and then lost. Remember, they lost to Hampton in 97. They had JoJo English. Another little guy, BJ Mackey.
This boy, man.
Shot ball. Oh, yeah. I saw that hoop. No, yeah, we go back. I mean, they lost the hand. That was like HBCU. And like, that's like unheard of. So getting to South Carolina, did you get homesick? Like, you know, man, I want to get back to Tampa. Like, I ain't really feeling this. Or you just made it work?
It was time to go at that point. Like, it was. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, y'all been to college, correct?
Yeah.
That's probably the best time in your life, man. You learning a lot.
You find yourself.
You on your own. You know what I mean? Yeah. Pretty much you got your own spot.
Even away to college is even better because that gives you a better opportunity. I graduated and went to the military.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a great. I tell people, if you can get away to go to school, get away to go do anything.
Please.
Get away.
Yeah.
You got to be exposed to something else.
I got to get into college. I got to get into memory. I got to take them down memory lane. Liveest arena you ever played in college? Arkansas beat Crump, Tennessee beat Crump.
I was finna say Tennessee just because of the warm up line. I can't think, what's this guy name? Wilborn, wherever that was in there. They had the livest warm up line I have ever seen. They broke our backboard. I mean, not the backboard, the shot clock. Now they were dunking that bitch so hard. I ain't gonna lie to you. So he's looking like, okay. So, but I think like Kentucky. That was amazing.
And playing Rupp, that's special.
That was amazing. Florida was crazy. Yeah,
it was Matt Barnes, Hollywood. Matt Walsh.
Yeah,
the boys was Hollywood then.
Okay, they were coming.
Man, Mike Walsh was dating a porn star.
I remember that.
And
yeah,
they have like they practicing with their jewelry on, warming up. Like we couldn't wear our jewelry and stuff like that. So I'm like, okay, this is a little next level. And we ate their ass up. We ate them up that game. If I talk basketball, I'm going to talk a little different. I'm sorry.
We're going to let you go tonight.
Especially because of whooping Florida.
But I think something else, too, though, is that, like, to make the moves that you made, man, like I said, I'm always wanting to give people their flowers. I'm not. We're going to get back into, you know, what y'all got going, but it's just amazing to me. The top player in the state.
I'm still processing that.
Not to get that opportunity.
And you went to the University of Jefferson, who already had followings and buzzings in every sport.
And that's what I want to ask y'all.
So the connections were there.
Yeah, connections. I want to get into it. So do you feel what y'all going to do, and hopefully to get kids opportunities? Because I look at a lot of kids that play football, do different things. And it's like the sad thing is that these kids put so much into athletics. If it don't work, then they home. They in the street. They taking chances. And you don't want to see kids like that. So if you've been blessed with a gift, any coaches out here listening, man, do what you can to help these kids. If it's with their grades, you know, do the extra.
Even being honest with them would go a long way. This is where you are. This is where you're tracked. This is what you can do.
Because if he's the best player in the state, 4A, What is that to tell them?
Because I won every accolade, player of the year from Hillsborough County, tripping everything.
And obviously, if you got recruited by these schools, you know the other thing that was not an issue for him?
Grades.
There you go.
That's what I'm saying. So it goes.
But you got to say that though. True. It could have been an issue.
Yeah.
And see, that's part of what's irritating me in the back of my head is if you could get recruited by them, they already know what your academic background is. My other concern is what we're going to, I guess you'll discuss off air, but that's my other concern because you went somewhere where any other coach had a connection to say, hey, we got a guy that hoops here.
And I'm going to tell you, and I hate to say it, but they don't recruit in Tampa for basketball. I got another O.J. White scored over a lot of points at Chamberlain. He had to go to Barry. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, it is.
But he was a better player. Then going to Barry.
That's what's wrong with it.
And that's what I'm saying. So, as coaches, dig into your resources. You should be able to. There should be a pool.
Yeah, but your coaches should have.
That's what I'm going to.
You got a faculty. I mean, you got coaches who have connections with coaches.
But see, the thing with that too is, especially Hillsborough County coaches. They're the math teacher. They're the social studies teacher.
Okay,
like, they don't have that.
Waldo in. Waldo.
They don't have that connection. It's several coaches that have connections like that.
Those coaches
are the coaches that are winning in the area. Right. You know what I mean? So is the Jesuits, the
TC
Warwick Tinelli. Yeah.
Tinelli.
But you can't bring them into the same because he went to a public school. My point is we already know what the private schools can do.
Let's even do this. I can even go. I'm going to cut you off. King went to the four in 09 and only Torley. Fitzpatrick was the only one that went to school. Blake went to the four in 11.
But there was no any academic.
Academic, that's your job as the coach.
To get it straight.
Kids in position to where they can go to school.
Your academics help you a lot of times because you go from being a guy who might be a fifth guy. Your academics can get you number one and two.
Hold on, D.
So this is also going back to what TK trying to do with their program as far as getting their parents involved.
Right.
That's a whole nother issue as far as like you can't depend on somebody to take care of your baby the way you're gonna take care of your baby.
I agree.
You can't put that on the high school coach to make sure you get your grade.
Then it comes down to what's most important: is it winning or is it the kid? Because if I got a kid, I know hooping, but ain't got no chance, ain't gonna have no grades to go to school. Do I tell? You know, like so. I'm just.
Of course, you tell.
You support, but dogs, it don't. Everything don't go like that, bro.
Hey, look, son.
Come tell like this.
Like
okay.
I tell you, who wants to join the military? What did I tell them? Hey, looking back on it, I'm glad I did it. Would I've done some things differently? Yeah, but the one thing I tell kids now when they ask me, them bullets are real, son. Ain't no reset button on this.
Right.
Okay. But you see so many kids now.
They
tell them the truth.
They great. they playground legends. Went to school, played ball, got off, did their thing, and just got caught up. Because they didn't get a chance to go to school. And I think something else with that is that when expectations have been set, because, you know, and now we got social media, which is really crazy.
That's what
so you sit back and think, there was no social media when you was hooping.
Right.
So now it's like, okay, you got the kids, now they sit around like, okay, I done graduated from high school. Well, bro, what you doing? Man, coach, I ain't doing that. You know, coach, I ain't get a chance to go nowhere. So now it's either go to school, go to HCC, or get out here in the street. Because, see, now you got people that look at you like, man, you ain't doing nothing. And I think that's something that would kill me.
But you can build a brand.
You can build a brand.
It's also easier to connect with colleges than it was now.
Easy.
I agree.
Now than it was
when
we was in school.
I definitely agree.
Because you got college coaches on IG, you got college coaches on Twitter, Facebook. And all you got to do is just keep sending them. At the end of the day, it's a hustle.
Right.
When it comes down to it. When I got my last five guys in school, I just got on Twitter. And I just started sending them their highlight tapes.
But see, here you go again. You did that. You come
from
the struggle. You understand.
Right.
Right.
You get it. And that's what we need more y'all.
But all parents don't get it.
Right.
We need. That's why you need that those type of clinics. Like, right. you gotta coach. This could be his first year volunteering. He's not gonna know the ins and outs. Don't have the catalog of how to reach all the coaches. This that don't know how to do the right practice plan, game plan, and rotations, calling the right play. They just don't know. They volunteering. And what happens with the city? When I one of the main reasons why are we doing this is because when I went to school, I really had a problem. Like, why I wasn't recruited? I wanted to know.
Right.
They told me the two main reasons in Hillsborough County. They said, first, we don't transition well once we get to school. We get homesick and we flunk out. Two, we don't know how to. We don't have solid programs. Right. Mm-hmm. Programs meaning, if I look at Hillsborough County, no disrespect to nobody, and if I look at Chicago, somebody else.
Yeah, just go to next county over. Go to Polk County.
Well, go to Polk County.
You go to Polk County. Yeah, where the Haven, Bartow, Avon Park. They got hoop over there.
But I don't know if they're getting paid like that. What I'm finna say is, like, these coaches, that's what I'm saying, like, these coaches in Texas, Chicago, some of these coaches get paid $100,000 compared to what our coaches here are getting paid. So if you do the math, if I'm a recruiter, I'm like, you know what? Where I'm going to go? What county I'm going to go to find the best kids? And that's already going to come to my program ready to play. A coach that's getting paid $100,000, because you already know this coach know his program. He got a system. Matter of fact, this coach done built community-based type. He's in the community.
Don't say that a lot, too.
The coach is in the community, and he's with the population of the kids.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's dedication, key. Commitment, and it's also – I was going to ask you about that. And by the way, this getting homesick thing, that's one of the things you need to tell the parents. You know, we parent kids. The reality is they got to go.
Mm-hmm.
Like I tell my son, eventually he's going to go.
Yeah.
Hope the hell he go quicker, but he's gone. Yeah. But, you know, the girls you hang on to, but the boy, hey, you have to be able to survive outside. My mom used to always tell me, baby, mother ain't going to always be here for you. I thank God my mom and dad are still here, but they always prepared you for the day that you have to move on. It's about your kid's life.
Absolutely.
But these excuses y'all giving to these coaches, I ain't trying to hear it.
I ain't going
to
lie.
I can't handle that, bro.
I ain't gonna hold you. Listen, when I graduated, I was ready to go.
But I think that's something else, too. We all had that sense of independence.
Different
we ready to get out and get on our own. But I think something else, too, just like what TK was getting back to, as far as the responsibility, and like you said, okay, maybe in Chicago, D.C., larger areas, basketball is taken. And that what we need for Tampa is to take basketball more as an outlet, the same energy we get football. Because football is here. Cheaper. But I'm just saying, but football is here. Basketball is, like I said, now we got some young guys coming up this year that's going to make some noise.
Mm-hmm.
And we got some sophomores, freshmen, going to come and expect it to make some noise. But with that being said, it's different now because I think it's more put into it. Like now you got the AAU circuit has taken off, blown up. Because back in the day, AAU was.
Wasn't everybody, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Was what three teams?
Three teams.
You also had to earn. Well, I don't know.
Yeah, but see, nowadays
when I didn't play basketball, but then AAU had to be.
I remember AAU and AAU in Atlanta. It was the 12 best high school kids in the city.
Period.
Somewhere like, oh, my daddy got the team. I'm the 10th best player, but I'm a star.
No.
We ain't doing that.
When Florida Elite used to go out of Memorial, you go into Florida Elite, you go into the gym, and you got 30, 40 players in the. And you only got three teams. So you had what? Florida Elite, Brandon Boats, and Summerfield Warriors.
Right.
And may have another team that I didn't know about, but it wasn't. It's the 10 best.
Yeah,
it might take two more, but the 10 best guys, you had to make it.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Even like, did you play AAU?
A little bit.
A little bit? Yeah, okay.
Not really. With Spirit. Right.
Spirit, okay.
I forgot about Spirit.
And I think, now let me ask you this. Do you think that what it's going to take, and I won't try to do this, I mean, just in thought, in your clinic, we got to get more exposure as far as, say, maybe scheduling other top teams as far as putting that, that's a bus ride.
They just
economics, too, isn't it? We talk to the coaches about that, too. It's not that the coaches don't want to. It's that
school board.
At one point in time, it was public schools couldn't participate in sports outside of the district.
What you were saying, Waldo?
Yeah,
it's funded in the county. Like it's like right now they short bus drivers. Even to get a bus to go to these places, they don't have a driver to take them. They ain't got enough funding in the county.
They're not allowed to use buses this year. Yeah. From what we heard.
Wait.
Yeah, they're not even using buses. The coaches got to give them enough.
You have to have.
For what?
No. The coaches can't even the coaches can't even tell the players how to get there. Like after on your away games, you're not riding no bus. The players got to get there the best way they can, and the coach cannot say you and you ride together because that's
a liability.
So y'all just got to get there at 6 o'clock the best way y'all can. That's right. High school, man.
For boys or girls too?
Girls too.
Everybody except football. Every sport is like that.
And I was gonna say football.
Come on, hold on.
Don't even make sense.
Hold on.
Ain't that right?
Yeah. So I was just going to say football.
Wait a minute. The county budget is the county budget. The county budget that covers academics. See, now this is what, and I'm trying to stay rough and without becoming the other guy.
Okay, don't be that guy.
but the reality is, now we're getting into why civics is important, because we have people who obviously don't understand how local government works, and this is also why parents need to be participants. Beyond yelling and screaming on Facebook for your children, I said it. So you don't put it on none of these other guys in here.
But the reality is, if you are building houses
in Hillsborough County, their property taxes is how you fund the schools. So the money is there. You're not putting $600,000 houses up and getting money for taxes, and I can't get kids to sporting events.
Straight up.
Somebody look up the next Hillsborough County School Board meeting.
That's crazy.
And I'm going to say this. My kids, I was blessed. My son graduated from Jesuit. My daughter graduated from Berkeley.
So that don't change anything.
Private school don't got to worry about that.
But that, I don't care about that. I'm talking about the public school. Right. I went to the University of Thomas Jefferson High School. We didn't have these issues.
On Cypress Street, I know that, too.
What's the address? 441.
Before you say it, another
441. Okay, I think I went there. Everybody didn't get
feel like I went there.
You know, don't. You can
say
feel
what,
like
say what, Waldo?
So is the issue, like he's saying, the property taxes and all of that, but they putting up the property taxes, that they not going to build no houses by tech. They ain't building
but
no houses
by tech. Parent participation. You go down there and you tell the people that I vote for, this is what you're going to make sure happens.
Mm-hmm.
If you get my money.
So we're going to have some forfeits this year then.
No, this was like this last year as well, correct?
I had no idea.
Yeah.
So let's say if Leonard plays Leto.
Drive there.
Ruskin to.
See, the way they do it now is they try to schedule all the ones that's close. So I think
okay,
the coaches
cluster.
Get the. I
in
think
the cluster,
coaches,
like East Bay, so like.
Yeah, East Bay, Sumner,
Leonard,
Riverview,
Spoto.
Okay.
Brandon.
So all of that is that area.
Relax, dog.
Hey, man, listen. Hey, we go up.
Hey, this is how we were at August 3rd. When we was at Jefferson High School, we had to do the presentation of what we were trying to do for to help the Hillsborough County basketball
man, my
players.
My head is starting to hurt.
Man, this is what we've been on, man. I swear to God.
That's crazy. I'm still
unaware, and I apologize.
Hey, I wouldn't have been able to play. I wouldn't have been able to play. In today's, I wouldn't have been able to play.
You know what that does?
Because my mom worked. How's you going to get me to the
But how do you get continuity with your team if you can't guarantee that somebody's going to be there? But beyond that, you don't even build, I won't say esprit de corps, that's military, but you don't build the kind of camaraderie that you would need. We're talking about bus drivers, and we're talking about people who don't put anything into the kids, but somebody, I guarantee you one thing, I bet you nobody's salary on the school board went down.
I bet you that.
I know y'all got a mayor out here who, okay, I ain't got nothing against your public service workers who just got a 20% raise, right?
And they're going to raise property tax after Ian. They spoke about that today.
Because you got insurance companies that are
going to
solve it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I don't want to go into that other guy because, you know, I like to continue to look like this guy, but the reality is, when you have insurance companies going under, then the state of Florida ends up picking up the policies of the ones that go out. So, you know, you always have your insurer of last resort. But I'm back on Hillsborough County. Anywhere in the 72 counties of the state of Florida, we should not have a problem getting young men and women to their sports.
That's crazy. I'm still like,
where is the lottery money going?
District in the nation.
Say what, Waldo?
Where's the lottery money going? That's supposed to go to the school. Where the lottery money?
Lottery money should have been a supplement. And I know I remember when the lottery. I was in the military, I think, when they started it, though. But the lottery money was a supplement. So if your budget was say $100 million and the lottery made $40 million, you're not supposed to take 40 out of the budget and put it somewhere else and appropriate it somewhere else. Then you now should have 140 million or whatever the percentage of the lottery money was. So, well, look, there's been a lot of misappropriating of funds and, you know, Brett Favor. Okay. Stuff
keep,
like that.
Hey, keep your punches up, man. Listen.
Hey, listen, bro. Listen, you're talking about misappropriating of funds. We're sending immigrants to Martha Vineyards with a misappropriation of funds.
Yeah.
I can't get kids to school to games, but I can spend $12 million to have my buddy make money to send a few immigrants for political purposes to Martha Vineyards. I believe $12 million we could cover a school bus driver.
Right? Martha Vineyards. Agreed.
So listen,
hey, this is not the media.
We don't want that. That's what we're here for. I'm on all that. So look, hey, with that being said, we're going to take our halftime break. We come back. We're going to have a wrap with Ryan. We're going to breeze through the college games real quickly. We're going to get back into this fiasco going over this hoop. So the next two sponsors
this affects every sport but football.
Excuse me. So all the sports in Hillsborough County. Schoolboy, y'all should be ashamed of yourselves, man. Y'all got to do better.
You know, parents who don't show up at school board meetings should be ashamed of yourselves.
He getting that Joe Clark. Now, let me go to a break. He about to crack up.
Yeah.
So with that being said, we're going to give a shout-out to our sponsor, my man Carlos at Auto Repair Center, 813-443-47. Oh, yeah, Eagles fan. They undefeated. Anybody undefeated, he ride with. And you see with me and my man Ruff rocking these Chop Shop shirts, man. Check us out. Elevated Designs, 813-400-7015. We come back. We're going to have a wrap with Ryan, and we're going to get in the college games real quick. Don't take our halftime. We take this halftime break. Get us out of here, Serge.
Student body,
man, Joe Clark, me rough in here cutting up. We finna get into this, man. We're gonna have a conversation after this. So we're gonna do this real quick. We got rap with Ryan for the come on with us. I know she's studying. Let's go through the Zoom, Serge. Ryan, you ready?
I'm stepping in for Ryan today.
Okay, no problem. We got my man. Hey, one of the sponsors of the show, man.
I need Ryan because she don't put a little.
But no, Ryan gave you the pick. Now Ryan went 2-1 this week.
No, but Ryan gave you that watch.
Yeah, she 75. So give us the two show nuffs and then the one watch out.
Okay. No. All right. For show nuffs, she said the Bills over the Steelers.
Okay.
She biased for this one, the Chiefs over the Raiders.
Okay, then what's the watch out?
Hey, wait, where are the Chiefs playing the Raiders?
Monday night, Kansas City, Arrowhead.
I'm taking the Chiefs.
Okay, and what's the watch out? Because she 2-1, she 3-1 on the watch out. What's the watch out? The
Chiefs too. He said the Jets will defeat the Dolphins.
Jets will beat the Dolphins. Okay. Okay, so we got the Bills. We got the Bills. We got the Chiefs. And we got the Jets. The JT. Jets have won 2 in a row. They high.
I would say Jets 3-1.
Terrible. Okay. Terrible. Dolphins. Hey, Ryan, she 3-1 so far. I'm smelling what she's selling. Hmm. I'm on that. Hey, so look, and don't forget now, we kicking it with you on the 25th, so don't forget, Marcus.
I got you.
Okay. Well, go get back. Go back like old folks say, let her go to do her lesson. Yeah. And we'll be hollering at you.
And then y'all keep doing your thing, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you, bro. Appreciate you. Okay, as you see, we got AMG and Kenny. Well, what's up, man? What were you? You was at the Sunday night game in Tampa with my horse. So you got the Chiefs hat on.
Well, he's trying.
Yeah, he's showing. No, I was there.
He's showing up.
Kobe, come on, Kobe, man, tighten up, man.
Hey, what's all bad for all though?
Yeah. Kobe ain't even no Chiefs fan. He like the Falcon.
I like Mahomes.
He like Mahomes.
It's gonna be 3 weeks in a row.
Don't get him started. Brady done got that divorce lawyer. Yeah, he's going to be sick this week. But we're going to run this real quick, man. We'll get back with TK. We're going to run these football real quick, Waldo. So I'm going to call the games out. Tay, I know you picking. Serge picking. So we're going to have some fun with this. So TK, just chill. We're going to run this real quick. We're going to be long. Thursday night, like SMU. I'm going to start with Waldo first. SMU at Central Florida. Central Florida getting 3. Who you like?
I like SMU.
Oh. AMG, who you like?
He changes.
Mustangs.
Tay, who you like?
Stains.
Okay. Stain?
Yep.
I'm going to set the floor at home, going under, too. Take the under.
Okay. Serge, who you riding with? SMU. Okay, so.
Always take
the under. Hold on, Dave, who you said? South, to the floor, SMU. I'm going,
man. You got to go with the teacher, not the student.
Okay, so he got I got SMU too. Hey,
don't think them NIL deals for the whole team gonna help y'all.
Okay, week. Nebraska with their new coach favored by 3 at Rutgers. AMG, who you liking that?
Give me Rutgers.
Okay,
I'm taking over.
You take who?
I'm taking the over with Rutgers. Over.
Who you like on Nebraska?
Nebraska is terrible this year.
Okay,
and they were last year. Why didn't you get?
I like Rutgers too. Who you riding with?
Give me Josh Youngblood, Berkeley Prep graduate over there at Rutgers. Yeah.
Sir, who you got?
Rutgers.
Dade City.
Yeah, I'm going to go with Rutgers, man. I ain't seen nothing in Nebraska.
Okay. Another AAC matchup. Houston at Memphis. Memphis getting 3.
Memphis is getting 3?
No, Memphis giving 3. Upside that favorite by 3. Excuse me.
I won't. Give me Memphis.
Yeah, I take Memphis to my man, Sutton Smith, over there. Who you riding with, Squid?
Where are you playing?
At Memphis. Always the second team who I call that. That's what I'm on.
Okay,
you got to do that Joe Club. Try to go
back to TK. Give me Memphis.
Okay.
You said Houston.
Houston at Memphis.
Let me go Houston.
Okay, Tay going against the grain. Start out. Go ahead, AMG. Who you got?
D-Rose.
Okay, D-Rose. Okay. Sir, who you got?
Give me Coach Penny.
Coach Penny, okay. Dade City.
I'm going with Memphis.
You're going to Memphis. Hey, and notice Dade City got his white styrofoam drinking on that. You know that lead out there.
Hey, you know I'm in Texas, dog. You hey, I'm in Texas.
You know that Drake that dripped out is okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's a double up. Purdue at Maryland favored by 3. That Waldo like Purdue.
No, you don't.
Hey. Yes, he do.
They Purdue.
Yeah. You like Purdue?
Purdue tough. Purdue tough. But I ain't going with Purdue, though. I'm going with Maryland.
Okay. AMG, who you got?
I'm going to try Purdue.
Okay. Ruff?
They're at home. You mean Maryland.
Okay. I like Purdue. Who you got?
I'm not picking Purdue in nothing.
Okay.
I'm on Maryland with the over.
Serge. Purdue.
But two okay. Tonga Valois, brother.
Yeah.
Okay, Louisville favored by 4 at Virginia. I like Louisville.
I know that's definitely an under.
Yeah. Serge?
Yeah. At Virginia?
Yeah.
Let me go with Virginia.
Okay. AMG?
I like the Birds.
Okay. Dane City?
Give me Lil Lamar. I like Malik Cunningham, man.
Okay.
Virginia's going to cover. Give me Virginia to win.
Okay. Tell you got Virginia, you got Louisville.
Louisville.
Okay. Game day, first time ever at Kansas. Hosted TCU. Kansas is getting 7. Who y'all like?
That ain't enough.
I like TCU by 21.
That ain't enough.
Running clock, okay. AMG, who you riding with?
Give me Kurt Thomas.
Okay. Old school. Okay, check you out.
Kansas got to show me something.
Okay. What you got, Dave City?
Kansas is 5-0. Kansas, game day, first time, they're going to be crunking Kansas. But give me TCU.
Hey, he just did the how he set you up. Tay, how do you ride TCU big? Ruff, who you ride with?
Man, this is going to be brutal. This is gonna be a welcome to reality moment for
So it's gonna get ugly?
Yeah, I think it's gonna be bad.
Second half, you watching something else?
Well, I might be watching something about second quarter.
Okay.
I ain't watching it.
Now I know a game near dear to my man Tay is hard. The Longhorns, Red River Shootout, man, Oklahoma, yeah, Texas favored by 7.
Shoot out both of them.
Give me whoever Texas playing.
Okay.
He must have seen Oklahoma last week.
Man, that was terrible. Dude.
Andrew, who you
he
got?
He must have seen Oklahoma last week. Huh?
I don't care who Texas playing. You know who I'm
with. Ruff, who you ride with?
You picking your toes,
man. Neither one of them are any good. Man, give me Texas.
Sir, who you got?
Let me get Texas.
They gonna mess around and fire, what you call this?
You had TCU too, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Oklahoma?
No, Texas.
Okay. I already know who Tay like. Tay Rabideau. Okay, that's SEC, fine. That is tricky. Tennessee favored by 3 at LSU. Now they're in Baton Rouge. 12 o'clock game, though, so they'll still be dropping Friday night. Who you ride with, Dave said?
Hendon Book.
Okay, that's enough for me. I like Tennessee also. Ruff, who you like?
Tennessee. LSU's
all right.
AMG,
who you got?
It pains me to say Tennessee.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, I'll go with Tennessee.
Everybody, Tennessee. don't want to upset Waldo, UCLA, who just lost it, who just beat Washington last week. Got them off their undefeated season. Hosting Utah. Utah's favored by 4. I like UCLA.
Give me Utah. No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you do not.
I like UCLA. I'm trying.
I ain't trying Utah. I'm taking Utah. Them gangbangers ain't going to do nothing to Utah.
Okay.
Man.
Sir, who you riding with?
Give me Charles O'Bannon.
Okay.
Wow.
I like that. AMG, who you got?
Give Kareem.
Who?
Kareem.
Kareem.
Okay, Cap. Listen. Let me tell you something.
Cap.
I'm going to quote the late, great Kuda Patterson out of Ebo City. One thing Kuda always told me. Can't call in sit. The game got to be played. And you ain't got nothing to do with who's going to win it.
Right.
The game got to be played. So for that being said, my partner, Kuda P, I'm taking UCLA. Okay.
Utah.
University of Miami. Hosting North Carolina. Miami getting 4.
They ain't getting enough.
I'm taking North Carolina.
That's crazy.
I'm riding with Tay.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm riding. Me and Tay ride. We ride pretty decent. Yeah, sir, who you got?
You know what? I'm going to go with Miami.
Okay. AMG?
I'm going to go with the Hurricanes.
Okay. Wild Day City.
So, since we're talking about Hurricane, he ain't gone. So,
okay,
all the Hurricanes
are
dead. Nobody lost the middle of Tennessee.
Miami.
Hurricane dead, so I'm going with North Carolina.
Bro?
Miami.
Okay.
They're not going to lose twice in a row.
Okay. They ain't like they can't. I'm telling you, y'all be saying like, they ain't like they can't.
They ain't like
they can't. Hey, we got 2 spread games that we was off last week. Ohio State is getting 27 at Michigan State. Does Ohio State cover?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
They're gonna fire. What you got, Dave City?
I really think Michigan State is a really formidable opponent. A very tough team.
Do they cover 27?
I like Ohio State to cover.
Okay. AMG, what you got?
I like Ohio State by far.
Serge, I already know Serge got.
Yeah, you ride with the Buckeye?
This is going to be ugly, bro.
Okay, ugly. Fire this brother. And the other spread game is going to be the get-back game. Nick Saban accused Jimbo Fisher of getting money. So A&M goes to Alabama. Alabama is giving 24. They're gonna beat Texas A&M to death. They need to get Johnny Football and Mike Evans back for them. They're gonna get beat to death.
I don't know, D. Is Bryce Young gonna play?
Huh?
Bryce playing?
Man, they go get Greg McElroy from SEC Network. they gonna beat the snot out of Texas A&M. So I ain't gonna fall for the banana tailpipe. Listen, 8 o'clock game in Tuscaloosa, Jimbo Raiders bow by Nick Saban.
Hey,
that's that get back.
Alabama already got their wake up call.
Yeah. So,
I think A&M can do it.
Okay.
Just because I don't like Alabama.
Okay. That's fine. No problem. Tell who you riding with.
A&M not good, so give me Bama.
Okay. AMG, who you riding with?
You could have gave me 34.
Yeah, what he said. Okay. All right, we got four more games.
Give me A&M.
Okay, you better insert by yourself. Kansas State favored by 2 at Iowa State. I like the Cyclones. I got to try them. I'm stuck on them. I can't shake them.
They don't never seem to come through when they need to. Give me Kansas State.
Okay. Ruff, who you got? I mean, Squid, who you got? Not Squid. Walter, who you got?
Oh, I'm going to go with Adrian Martinez and Kansas State.
Okay.
Ohio State and Kansas
State? No, Kansas State at Iowa State. Kansas State getting 2. Favored by 2.
I'm taking
Kansas State?
I'm taking Darryl Sproles.
Okay, respect. Sir, who you got?
Let me get Iowa.
Iowa State, okay. For the upset, okay. AMG, who you got?
I'm going to take Josh Freeman.
Josh Freeman, okay.
Hey,
cool, Josh Freeman.
Yeah, that was when you was
a fan. He was in the city. That's another conversation. Illinois, famous by 4. Huh?
That was when he was a Buck fan. We ain't going to talk about that.
Yeah, that's another story. Iowa at Illinois favored by 4.
Whatever what's the under? 17?
20. I don't know. I like Iowa. I'm going to try Iowa.
TK, what's the under in that game? About 20?
What you got, Dave? Say who you got? Iowa, Illinois.
They playing in Iowa?
Playing at Illinois.
Who they playing?
Iowa, Illinois.
Give me Iowa. I like Iowa. Iowa going to play defense.
Okay.
Both of them.
Serge, who you got?
Iowa.
All right. Illinois. AMG?
Iowa.
Okay.
Illinois is going to kill
them. Say who you riding with?
Iowa.
Okay. Illinois so, scared by itself. Okay.
Kill him.
Notre Dame, favored by 3, hosted BYU. Not host, they play BYU in Las Vegas. 2 Catholic schools. That's going to be different.
That's a Mormon school.
Okay, excuse me. I apologize.
There's something I ain't going to watch. But, yeah. I'll take BYU.
I'm going to take BYU, too. They whoop South Florida. I'm trying BYU. Who you like?
I need that Notre Dame for the strength and segment win.
Okay. Selfish, okay. Ruff, who you got, Ruff?
Let's go with Notre Dame. I get a brother.
You got Rudy, there. Okay.
They're going to get on, they on track.
AMG, who you got?
They're terrible.
I'm going to take Zach Wilson.
Okay. Dave City.
I'm going with the Fighting Mormons, man. I like Jimmer.
I'm going to take Jimmer. Okay, we got 2 more. FSU traveling to Raleigh, taking on NC State. NC State lost their first game last week.
So did we.
NC State's so favored by... Okay. And so did Florida State. NC State's favored by 3.
I'm taking the over with NC State.
Okay. I like how you do these speech. So eloquent. I'm taking the over with NC State. Who you like, sir?
Give me Charlie Ward.
Okay. Chuck, AMG, who you got?
Big Florida State, none.
Keep your energy.
I'm going to take NC State respectfully. Dave City, FSU?
Yeah, you can go ahead and put me down for Tiger Jackson now.
And you got who you got?
Charlie Ward.
Charlie Ward, okay. All right. And I already know who you got. I ain't got to ask you.
Yeah, yeah, my brother got his last game. But that don't
pro matter. Game on Thursday. Indianapolis Colts 2-2. Going to Denver, taking on the Broncos. They 2-2.
The horses are playing. Man.
That's another game. Who we got? I like Russ at the house.
I do too.
Keeping the NC State. Who you got?
Give me Sierra.
Sierra, okay. Who you got, Russ?
I like Russ too.
Okay.
And the under.
You like Matt Ryan?
Yeah, we'll go Matt Ryan.
Okay. AMG.
This game is awful. Give me the Broncos.
I'm watching this game.
Okay.
Dave
City.
It's gonna be a good game.
Hey, Russell Wilson bought Sierra her freedom papers. So I'm gonna ride with Russell Wilson. He bought a Masters, man. He got to work out for something, man. He gonna come.
He did that some years ago.
Who you got now? Who you got?
I like Matt Ryan.
All right. AMG, I thank you for coming on, kicking it with us, man. What game you going to this weekend? You going to I know I got some preseason games going. You gonna maybe check out a Lakers game this week? Or you might be an Arrowhead for the Monday night game.
I could have got some tick last night.
I can't miss that.
Game, we stopped playing.
Okay. Like Waldo said, let's say Ed, you got your hat on this week. Hey, Waldo, real convenient, ain't it?
Hey, it's crazy, ain't it? Crazy, boy. He ain't had a Chief hat on all year.
Hey, that's what they do when they win. So, hey, AMG, appreciate you kicking it with us, man. I ain't gonna hold you up. I know you got stuff you got to get to. So, hey, peace and love, bro.
That's it.
All right, thank you. Let's get back into it. We got these college games out the way. We still kicking with TK. TK, I want to ask you something. Now, we just spoke about off record. We were talking about the importance of giving kids opportunities as far as, say, scholarships, exposure, like I say, interacting with the parents. What do you think, and this is always, I always ask people, because when it comes to athletics and academics in Hillsborough County, it seems like athletics is always what takes the precedent over academics. So the parents are only into hoop, ball, whatever it is to get that look. But you got to have the grades to get. And you, Exhibit A, you had the grades, so there was no reason that you should have gone through your story. But like I say, something greater came from it. And I'm, glad that worked out for you. But what message are you trying to give parents in a couple weeks? Because you're going to have some resistance. And I just know that with our people. That's you're going to get that. So I don't know who's more of the diplomatic out of the two. I know Tay's a loose cannon, so you probably got to keep him.
But Tay's an actor. He's also works in the school system, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tay's a coach. Tay's a coach. Tay's a different. We're gonna talk about Tay during the show. Right? Tay's a different kind. You and Tay got a lot of similarities.
I work at USF.
You'll take a lot of similarities.
I guess it'd be an insult.
So I guess TK going to be the one that's... because you're going to have a parent like, okay, well, my kid should be doing this. It's
terrible.
And I think that's the thing that I used to coach. And I coach, I ain't coach them a rec ball, but the parents today are so involved with their kid making it, they overlook so much stuff.
They're too involved. Emotionally.
Absolutely. The number one thing they need to look at is being the grades. No matter what, I don't care how good he is.
Spoken like a dragon.
You cannot do nothing without grades, period. Okay. Then also, I was one of those kids where my mom believed in me. She had a dream that I was, she had a dream that I made it to the NBA, and she always told me that. I had a dream, God showed me you made it to the NBA. So if a parent has that dream about their kid, there's nothing you can stop that. Now it's up to that kid is to actually believe what their parent told them. If they had that dream themselves, go no matter what nobody tell you, still follow through as hard as you can with your dream.
But you work hard too, right?
And work hard with it.
Say that part again, right?
You know what I'm saying? Like most, like he just said, is grades, executing all the way through with your dream, with your family, that potential that they see in you. Those are the first people that discover that potential. It's your family members. But it also takes that hard work, that dedication, that relentlessness of just not going giving up and taking those no's for answer. But at the same time, we are going to tell you the truth. I think it's only, 450 NBA players or something like that in the league?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then I don't know the number of how many Division I colleges, but when you were speaking about O.J. and Barry, I'm sorry, but it's any college that you get a scholarship from, it's a great opportunity.
Absolutely.
It's a great opportunity.
To piggyback off what you're saying, the parents, like me coaching AAU ball, and I hear so much unrealistic stuff. The parents got to be realistic about what's going on. You're
telling that again, man.
Parents got to be realistic
you
about.
Know, sometimes your child just sucks.
It's not even suck.
Or they don't have next level. Okay, sucks may be hard, but they don't have next level potential.
They don't have D1 talent. They have D1 talent. Like, oh, I want to go D1. Like, that's not the only thing that's going. Yeah, you like, play, right, you see some high-level JUCO games.
Yeah, but like I said, it's an opportunity. Yeah, if you get a look. It's free college. I tell people all the time, like I say, it's opportunity.
Right.
And have tournaments, like I think about.
I don't mean to cut you off. I don't mean to cut you off, D, but let's get TK to talk about. Let's get TK to talk about opportunities overseas as well. Because everybody think if they don't get to the NBA, their career is over with. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? So like, it's other avenues outside of making it to the NBA. There's other avenues outside of going D1. If you go D1, you might not make it to the league from a D1, but you can go. You can go play in Turkey. You can go play in Israel. You can go play and make that bag. So it's other avenues instead of just going, I got to go D1.
That's facts. But I think
it's other avenues, and you just got to realize sometimes your kid they don't have D1 potential. But they continue to work on their game. They continue to get better every day. At the end of the day, they might have opportunity. They might have a shot to go somewhere else and still progress as a professional basketball player, progress as a professional athlete. You know what I'm saying? So it's other opportunities, and they just got to keep working on their craft. That's the main thing. And if they don't get them grades, that craft is over with.
Respect. Amen. And piggyback off of what you just said, I think the main goal for these kids, they just want to be a professional. You know what I'm saying? Just be a professional, be a professional athlete. Okay, you want to get to the NBA, you want to get to this level, that level. But also going D2, D3, you still, when that season is over with, if you play well, you probably get a chance of go somewhere, showcase somewhere, and get a chance to play. You might have to start at a lower level overseas, but if you play better, work your way up, of course you're going to get another opportunity to be seen. And that's why I want to bring up this point. A lot of guys, like you were saying earlier, a lot of guys at high school, they stop playing after high school ball. They don't got no offers or nothing like that. What happens to them?
Right.
Nine times out of ten, some people be late bloomers. They develop their skill set a little bit later.
True.
You have to get around the right coach to develop you. But if you don't get that offer to get developed, you just sit here and be undeveloped, and now you're feeling sorry for yourself, and now you're trying to make a home run decision that's going to lead you in a lot of problems.
Are there basketball camps and coaches like the way we know Trevor does what he does? Are there basketball coaches who help to cultivate skills for players who may be tweeners or the ones who finish high school? Are there camps or places they can go that allow them to cultivate their skills?
Not that I'm aware of.
I'm not aware of either.
Yeah, so once you finish high school and you really haven't had a shot. Like you really got to walk on somewhere. Like you might not be where you want to be, but you might have to walk on somewhere, man. Like,
well, see, the thing but you're talking about basketball, and I'm thinking about, because basketball rosters are the smallest professional or the smallest roster of any of the sports anyway.
Right.
Even volleyball has a bigger roster than basketball.
Mm-hmm.
So to what you were saying, and probably to your passion like mine is. You got to be really, really good in basketball.
In Hillsborough County.
Especially, not even that.
No, I mean just in general, to get, because basketball, the opportunities are limited. Because you also, you got your guards, got your forwards, you got very few centers.
Now we got the overseas element, the dynamic. Well, they coming over now, they playing.
Like, they seem to be more technically sound for some reason. I don't understand why
they start. They start younger. They start playing with adults earlier. We talk about Luca's been playing basketball since he was 14 years old, playing with adults, professional.
Yeah. Okay,
so we go. Let's piggyback there. We go get back into this, man. Our last break. We're brought to you by man in TK's neck of the woods, down there, downtown Carver City, man. Conan, Mike Trigg, Eric Trigg. Salute to y'all, man. 813-870-0404. Go check them out. Best barbecue in the city. I stand on that.
And I just found out he was an insurance adjuster, man. Shout out to Mike Trigg.
Okay, Trigg, wear a lot of hats. Okay, do your thing, boy.
Okay.
Sir, you going to give us a little something before we get for our last break. So we're back at it for the fourth quarter, man, of Chop Shop. And I want to get into it with TK. I like to kick it a little bit when I get my guys. Come on here, kick with me. Where were you when you got that call for the NBA? You know, like, what you remember what you were doing? Because that's something like that just sticks out. Like, you know, like, man, that's something you'll never forget.
Actually, what's the right there by the causeway when you right there before you go to WTR?
Rocky Point.
So okay. It's in that little corner, there's these villas.
Yeah.
Villas. That's where I had my draft party.
Get together. Soiree, whatever.
Chase. So
my uncle,
Chase Sweet, right
up. Tommy, shout out to Tommy Bell.
Hold on, say what, Waldo?
It went over there by Bahama Breeze, was it?
Before that, Bahama Breeze on the right. Soon as you come off the interstate, it's to the left.
Oh, Rusty Pelican is.
Sweet's right there.
Before that. Talking about where the hotel.
Where the
Hyatt
at.
Where the
Hyatt.
Oh,
behind the
Hyatt.
I know exactly what you're talking about. It used to be a club back in the day.
Okay.
I've got a name, but we just climbed the fence. That's another story, but go ahead, though.
Everybody. Yeah.
Everybody.
So I ain't going to. So we had the drive. We watched the drive there. My uncle, I remember getting out of the car. My uncle Tommy, this is my first time trying, what was that, Cristal. He had a bottle of Cristal. And he was like, no matter what, nephew, if you get drafted, it don't even matter. We are proud of you. I know where you're from. Yeah. You're from Carver City. And you got a degree.
Yeah,
and we proud of you for that.
Yeah,
so he gave it to that. He popped it. We both took a shot of that, and we watched the draft. And I was being told that I was supposed to get drafted late, like number 40, like late round, second round, like
okay,
very late. Ronaldo was went 22, I think. I went supposed to go like 46 or something like that.
Okay,
so we watching the draft. Next thing, no, I don't get called. Okay. So I ain't gonna lie to you, it hurt it.
Yeah.
It hurt it like a mug. It hurt it. Right after that draft, I got to skip some stuff. Right after that moment, okay, I go outside. Ain't gonna lie to you, I'm crying. My mom and them looking at me. The girl I was dating at the time, she looking at me. Like, what you gonna do, this, that, and the other. I just left out of there, went for a walk, and on my way back. My girlfriend at the time, she gave me a hug. My mama was right there. So I'm sitting on, they got this little thing over the water. Like, this side water and this side the steps. So I got my foot over there by the water, just looking at the fish. And my mom was like, boy, what's wrong? Don't you jump down now? I said, Mom, I'm not going to jump down now.
Shout out, Mama.
I said, Mom, I'm not going to jump down now, man. I'm just getting my thoughts right. And in that conversation, my phone rang. It was my agent, and he had Jerry West on the line. Jerry West was on the phone. He said, Torrance, we're glad that you didn't get drafted. You had an excellent workout. And we want you to come in. We're going to give you a partial guarantee, and we want you to come in and try to make the team. So I was happy as on the way. I'm like, well, okay, I got a partial guarantee, so I'm going to get a check to go make a team.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, man, I told my mom, I said, man, I'm going to go make this team. The very next day, I leave down there. I got down there 3 weeks before everybody got there. I'm working out. I wanted to learn the plays, get familiar with the coaches, to get some favoritism.
Right.
So we working out. Next thing you know, the day before training camp start, I go for a rebound. I get elbowed right here. I get a plate and 9 screws put. I broke 3 bones in my in my right cheek.
Oh wow!
So I'm supposed to be out for 6 months, and I still got to make this team. So I'm in the hospital. Before I even get to the hospital, I remember holding my eye, and I still can see. And my teammate like, bro, because I'm holding my eye, but he still can see my eye because all the muscles right here were blowed out to the side.
Oh,
so all this was puffy, and this was down. So my mom came. I'm in there. I had I think 4 surgeries on his eye. So I get a plate, 9 screws put in. Fast forward. I'm in the hospital for a week. I get out the second week. They still making cuts. They still playing, trying to make the team. So that second week, the coach and them come to me and say, you know what, Kenz, it's unfortunate what happened to you. We're probably going to have to let you go. So I was like, I remember at this time, I'm like, okay, I understand. So I'm not supposed to have no light contact or nothing. And I'm not supposed to get my heart rate up or anything. So I go to practice anyway. The next day, I'm talking about my eye this big. I'm just sitting on the sideline like this here because the light was hurting it. I'm watching every play, though. So every day, they telling me, Kenzie, how you feel? You got another game. Hopefully, you can't play, right? I said, I know. We got to cut you today. I said, man, you can't cut me today, coach. Can y'all please just let me be the last cut so I can get my best of my experience with the NBA? They said, we'll see what we can do. It was 4 games left. The very next day after they told me that, they came back a day and a half later, Kizzy, we gotta let you go, man. I'm like, damn. Gotta let me, all right. So I said, I called my agent. I said, man, they about to let me go. I said, I wanna play tonight. Remember, my eye's still big. They said, I wanna play tonight. They're like, you can't play. So I told the coach, I said, coach, what do I got to do to play tonight? He said, well, first thing first, we got to find a way to get the NBA to approve it. The NBA didn't approve it. They pretty much said, you got to get your primary doctor to approve it. And they said, pretty much, if you die, you die. That's on you. So my primary doctor signed and it said, I had to say, whatever happens to me, I take full responsibility.
Waiver. Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Waiver.
So I signed that. Then I was like, well, you don't know. This is a game against, my first game was Miami Heat. So they was like, you don't have a face mask or anything like that. I said, man, in the training room, there's a face mask. I believe that was Brian Cardinals. So Brian Cardinals.
Yeah,
Brian Cardinals had a face mask that he had used last year. So I used his face mask. I'm talking about it's not molded to my face. It's not, you got two big straps. So
yeah,
it's just loose, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I put that on. And they was like, well, do you know any plays, anything like that? I said, man, I know the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the sideline out of bounds, the baseline out of bounds, and the special team play. And not special team play, but the shot, and the shot clock plays. They're like, all right, back, go play. My first game in the NBA was, I ain't practiced over a month, got a plate 9 screwed, eye this big, scared as I don't know what, playing against the weight. Every time I room, I just feel like my cheek shaking. And long story short, through the grace of God, we prayed, me and my mama, like we do every game. I went out there and hooped. Played well. The first game played well. The second game, third. But my minutes was getting lower and lower. So I'm thinking I'm about to get cut. Like that first game I had 10. The second game I had like 8, 6. Then I had 8 the last game. I went from 27, 13, 12, then like 10 minutes or something like that. So at the end of the game.
Hold on. I don't mean to cut you out. Sir, can we go a little later? We know I'm stopping now. Okay, good.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay, this is good. Nice. Yeah, go ahead. Let's go. Let's run it.
So he's – so coach said – Kenzie, I just want you to know, man, you made the team. So I'm like, I'm thinking that it was – matter of fact, let me rewind the tape a little bit. I don't want to miss this part. So this is the last game against Richard Hamilton.
Was Hubie the coach then?
No. Damn, I can't think of who the coach was.
It'll come to you. Let go. Let's keep going.
I can't think of the coach.
So you had to guard Rip.
So I'm guarding Rip. Right, so I'm looking at Rip face mask.
I'm about to say hi too.
Way smoother than the mines, you know what I'm saying? So I'm looking at mines loose, you know what I'm saying? And I'm talking about Rip is cooking, bro. I'm talking about he had like a quick 17 and like in 5 minutes.
Run forever,
and I'm running off of every screen. I'm hitting every screen. So every time I hit a screen, it just feel like my cheek. I'm talking about pain, bro.
I feel you
hurting. So I'm at halftime. I remember sitting at halftime like this here with I put my helmet. There it is.
Mark, I don't even know who that is.
Averone.
Averone. Okay, yeah. He used to play for the Sixers back in the day. Whoever gave that, thanks for that heads up. Go ahead, keep going, brother.
So I had my mask on my knee. I'm just sitting there like, man, I'm about to get cut. Rip just got 17 on me real quick. And I'm sitting at a team left, and Coach Anderson come back in. And this is what we do for college. This is what Carlos Powell, like he called dog work every time we work out. Because we used to, no messing around, we used to eat dog food before we play big games, so just bite one. So during this thing, I said, you know what, I got to make this team. I grabbed my dog food and I bit it. And I remember it hurting so bad, so I had normal. I had to suck it and let it dissolve. And Coach Anderson walked up and be like, Kenzie. So I'm like, yeah, I had to talk with dog food in my mouth. I'm like, man. He said, are you sure you want to play some more? He said, you don't have to play if you don't want to. I said, man, I'm playing. He said, well, you finna start this second half. So on my way out, I grabbed a Muscle Milk drink to wash that down and went out there. And that's when I think I got my 8 points that second half. Mm-hmm. After that game, that's when coach was like, man, I just wanted to let you know, man, you made the team. And Junior Harrington and all of them, they couldn't even say nothing because Junior was supposed to make the team. He played well, too.
Okay.
They was like, based off of the way you came in with your injury and how you knew the plays, he said, you made the team off of the first game. And we dropped your minutes down because we were trying to save you a little bit, truth be told. Then they set me down, let me heal up for 6 months. After them 6 months, I had 2 weeks to practice. Mike Miller, Damon Jones, Eddie Jones, Mike Miller, and Damon Stoudemire. All three of them got hurt. So they was like, Kenzie, you want to hoop? Coaches threw me out there. That first game I had a dub. So, then after that game, Jerry West said, you think you could do it again? I said, if I play. He said, well, go out there. He said it. Go out there and do it again. Man, that last month in my rookie year, I won rookie of the month.
I remember that. That's such a great story. I'm telling you, like, it's you hear about certain things. I'm just sitting back now. I'm just like, man, that's how you can't make it up. You can't make that up. No cap. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's That's crazy. But that shows your dedication, and that's what these young people have to understand. And you did the sacrifice that you made to get there. You understand what I'm saying? And it's like a lot of people look at the NBA as you got, it's a players league, so you probably got about, say, maybe 40 to 50 guys that you, their story is pretty, you know, they played with the school, you know, really good.
It was the man.
Top draft pick. Yours is gutter, bro.
You got yours.
I mean,
from the mud.
I mean, ain't no, you know, ain't highly touted, highly acclaimed, highly recruited, under the radar. Your granddaddy was dead on as far as say, hey, we not wasting our time with this opportunity. But that's why I said that, and that triggers. That's a different kind of motivation because you know what's at stake.
Absolutely.
If I'm trying to get here, I want to eat.
Absolutely.
I want to eat. And I ain't going to let nobody take my plate.
That's one of the things I think a lot of kids don't hear from anybody else either is that, dude, I don't care what you did in school. I'm here to eat. I'm here to eat.
Right.
Even if I got to eat you, I'm here to eat.
That's like that Bradley Beal when he was talking to his AU.
Oh, yeah. That's classic. That's classic. And I ain't going to let, can't none of one of y'all beat me. I'll never forget what he said. And he gave it to him like it was. But I think today's ball player, social media, and then a lot of these kids are coddled.
That's
what I don't like. Get on your kids, make your kids accountable, because you have to set that example.
They're not really tough.
They're not mentally tough. They're not mentally tough. Like, you know, don't yell at my baby.
Don't yell at my baby. Gonna make it.
No, you can't.
Do you know when you go to college or overseas or NBA, your kid finna get cussed out?
Oh, yeah, no doubt about that.
Because you represent somebody's ability to pay their mortgage. That's what you represent.
Right.
I'm not going to lose my mortgage because you can't play. Or you don't, like you said, you knew the plays, which is not surprising you went to the University of Jefferson. But learning one play.
You have a 5-6 Jefferson play. Let me go to Waldo real quick. Cause I know.
But it matters. It's the mentality.
You're right. So I'm like, we just talk about with getting on your kid. Walt, Dane City.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Tell us your Tonelli story with he told you couldn't ride the bus.
Tonelli's story. Oh, Tonelli ain't give a damn about. He ain't care about none of that. So we was in Boca Ciega. We was in Dunedin.
Listen to this.
I played against Jimmy Baxter. So Jimmy Baxter was hot in high school. You know, top athlete in Pinellas County. One of the top athletes in Florida. So we played against him. I had a big play against Jimmy Baxter. And I thought the ball went out of bounds, and I stood staring at Jimmy Baxter, and the ball was still in play, and it hit a three. So when he hit the three, Coach Tonelli pulled me out of the game, so he hot. We go into the locker room, and he going off on me. In the locker room, I think we were down like 3 points or something, and he going to the locker room, he going off on me. So I went back at him. We cussing and arguing. Coach Tonelli said, hey, you're going to have to find a way back. From Dunedin, you're going to have to find a way back. All the way from Dunedin, I'm in there like, man, you got me messed up, dog.
You had to find a way back.
But no, I rode the bus back. But he kicked me out of the team. But I ended up like 2 games later, I got back. They let me back on the team. But it's just like coaches like that, like kids today, like, the coaches will probably let him run over them. You know what I'm saying? So they're going with that, bro.
Bro, when he told me that, I was like, what? He said, you got to find a way back. I'm like, what?
Straight up.
And he didn't even care. Like, Tonelli, like, I don't care how you get back.
Yeah,
let me give you another Tonelli story. So our first basketball game with Coach Tonelli, like, we the new, I was there the first class graduate, first year award ever played sport. Coach Tonelli, the quietest, the calmest, like, person outside of basketball. So, like, if you don't know him in the game, you ain't going to really know Tonelli. So, like, he's so quiet and calm and peaceful. And then he get in the game, like, he a different animal. You know what I'm saying? That competitive is bring it out of him. So, he been cussing at us, like, the whole summer league, the practices before the league start. But his teachers and his coworkers, they ain't never seen this Octonelli.
So he get in the game, he cussing, he throwing clipboard, he doing all this. And the teacher had a whole teacher meeting, bro. I told him, hey man, I think you need to calm down on the side. So they told us, like, they called the basketball players in there and they was like, well, we talked to Nelly and we told him that he going too hard on y'all, he gotta bomb. I was like, shit, I mean, hey, we've been dealing with this, bro, like the whole summer. Like, so hey, this man, what it was, crazy, you know man. What I'm saying?
Right.
And he kind of changed a little bit, but that dog was still in him, you know what I'm saying? And that's how he was. And me and him, we butted heads like both years, like my junior and senior year of high school, we butted heads. But after that, like now, nah, man, he got my picture in his office, you know what I'm saying? But
wow.
Yes, outside of that, like, me and him, like, man, we super cool right now. You know what I'm saying? Super cool.
Yeah,
good absolutely. Dude.
And I think
he just wanted the best for me and the player.
Right. But like you said, but he saw something in you. And, you know, sometimes that's tough love. You know what I mean? Yeah. And there's nothing wrong with it. But I think some kids today, they're not built for that.
At all.
Because when you get on their kids, they become fragile. Don't yell at my baby. Don't scream. Don't do all that.
You're supposed to be able to take your kid to the court or to the field, and then you let him go. That's the coach.
But the game doesn't change.
Yes.
So wait a minute. Before we get out of here, I'm going to get back to TK. We got to pick these high school games. Dave City, you picking?
Yeah, I'm going to pick. I just want to tell TK one story. When your senior year, I was stationed in South Carolina at Sumter. And I went up to 5 points, man. Y'all had the club. You and Ronaldo had the club so lit, bro.
Man, he is gonna
y'all had the club so lit, bro. And I'm going to tell you, hey.
I
came in the club.
Hey, Walt, you remember the name of the club? What's the name of the club?
I don't remember the name of the club. I don't remember. We was in 5 points, though. And I walked in, and I came in the club. I said, man, both of them niggas, they're from Tampa, dog. So I walk in, and I'm with my homeboy. I said, bro, put on for the city. He said, hey, man, get this nigga some drinks, bro. Man, get the nigga some drinks, bro. I said, bro, I sure appreciate it, bro. We was in there, but y'all had that been lit, bro.
That's love. Hey,
I appreciate it.
We was 5 points, bro. It was probably 05.
Wow. Yeah, TK had a key to the city. He had a key to the city. Hey, he had a key to the city. Hey, they put on real decent, though.
The head.
They played Kane Wayne with it.
They might did, cause they were playing Kane Wayne, but they were doing the Kane Wayne dip. They had like a little line dance for the Kane Wayne.
Hey, we'll get to the real quick. Wingstop Chop Shop of Super 13, brought to you by Wingstop. Got 4 locations in the Bay Area. Actually, they got more, but my partner, we got one in Wesley Chapel, one in Luce, one right down 56 of Bush. And where it all started, right down 3rd to Fowler, 813-903-9464. Going to get some of them corn here soon. We get out of here. All right. Gaithan, Bloomingdale. Bloomingdale won it last, too. I'm going to try Bloomingdale.
I don't know why. Let's go with Gaithan.
Tay, who you got?
Gaithan for sure.
Bloomingdale.
Dane City, who you got?
Gaithan.
Okay. Gaithan. All right. Carrollwood Day at Lemon Bay. I'm going to try Carrollwood Day. I'm going to represent the city. I'm going to try them. Spoto and Lato.
Carrollwood Day. Spoto.
Lato 2-3. They just got to be 7-1 donut last night, though.
Dang. Give me Spoto.
Jazoo.
Oh. Yeah.
But they're going to beat Spoto. No, anybody trying?
I like Spoto.
Okay.
They still Lato.
Okay. Tell who you ride with.
Go Lato.
All right. Who you ride with, Dayson?
Can't pick Lato, man. Give me somebody else.
Okay. Robinson at Freedom. Freedom ain't won a game yet. I'm going to take Robinson.
Did they score?
They have scored. Okay. Not a lot. But I like Robinson. You Robinson. Same thing?
Yeah, Robinson.
Well, Plant for it. No, I'm sorry. Not Plant. Alonzo at Riverview. Alonzo just lost 37 into Plant City. It was undefeated. No longer in the 13. They fell out.
I want Alonzo.
All right. I'm gonna take Alonzo to Riverview 3-2, but I'm gonna try.
At home too. Give me Riverview.
Okay.
They run that beer still.
Dave City, who you got?
I'm gonna go with the Sharks. You know my mama in Apollo Beach. She right up the street.
Okay. Lego. All right. Getting into the 13. Sumner, who just lost to Durant 14-13 at 13, hosting Leonard. Leonard yet to win a game. Some of them lost their last two, but I think some to get back this week.
They get out the schneid this week.
Yeah, okay. I was out there. I rolled past something, and I like the ambiance when I rolled by there.
Number 12 Plant plays their rival Jefferson Friday. Who you liking that day, Sid?
Plant.
Okay. Tay?
Plant versus who?
Jefferson. At Jefferson.
University. Say it right.
I'm gonna try Jefferson.
Plant.
I don't know where that is.
Okay.
University is. That
okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Tay say Jefferson. Yeah, I'm riding with him. And Tay got Plant. Okay. Zephyr Hill hosted South Southern. South Southern ain't lost a game. I don't think Zephyr Hill gonna beat them. I hate to say that, Marcus, but I don't think Zephyr Hill gonna beat them.
They're not.
South Southern tough.
I don't know nothing about South Southern.
A lot of bros over there.
Yeah.
A lot of bros.
I'm taking them.
Strawberry Crest lost to Plant 17-10. They host Middleton. They number 10.
Crest.
Yeah. But Middleton just beat Chamberlain 49-0 on their home.
Chamberlain ain't scored all year.
We're going to get to them. We're coming up on them. Number 9, Blake at King. King beat Brandon 35-0 for their first win. Y'all like Blake.
They're not going to win. Blake.
Blake. Shout out to McCullough Val over there, the principal. East Bay hosting Chamberlain.
East Bay.
Okay.
Jesus, say Chamberlain ain't scoring no points.
Yeah.
He ain't scored not 1 point all year.
Yeah, okay. Durant at Sickles. That should be decent. But I like Durant.
Durant.
I say Durant going to play. It's running the ball.
Tampa Cavity going down to Winter Haven. That's tricky.
Winter Haven.
Okay, Day City.
If they anything like my Winter Haven, it's going to be
ugly. I'm going to go Winter Haven too, man. I don't really like Tampa Cavity too tough.
Okay, that's fair. All but that Steinbrenner. Running clock. Everybody going to play this week.
Yep.
Hope they ain't got it for homecoming.
Probably.
Okay, our game of the week is Newsom hosting Warden. Both of them 5-1. Okay, we had Newsom.
Last time
I was okay, yeah, tech beat him 28-3.
And I told you it was gonna be a blowout. Give me Warden in the blowout.
Okay. Well, I don't know. Dave City alumni, so I ain't gonna try him.
Rawr.
No, it's gonna be Warden.
Okay.
Rawr.
It's a rawr, the Wildcat. Hey, then Waldo, your Jesuit played the Carroll City Cartel, Clearwater Central Catholic, CCC. Who you like in that?
I'm gonna go with the boys' school.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with Jesuit.
Who you man. Like?
Are they in Clearwater?
No, it's at Jesuit.
Okay, I like Diggers.
I don't know about
it. It's gonna be Clearwater because
they usually got a squad though.
They play tough.
No, Jesuit should have kept the quarterback.
And the number one team in the area, Tampa Bay Tech at Hillsboro.
Give me Tech.
Yeah, Tech just put up 75 last night.
40.
On Freedom. So let's get back until we got that out the way. So we got our games in. So let's get back with TK with this going through, like I say, making it to the NBA.
I got a question for you. I got a question for you. What was the one thing you remember most about playing for the Cleveland Cavaliers? Because I didn't know you played for Cavs.
Yeah.
I looked it up, but I was like, oh.
The most memorable
DK bless his heart. He's a Cleveland fan. He's from Cleveland.
Cleveland fan. That's why he can't control himself.
That's
he's
right.
Okay. Jersey. His love surge ain't tripping.
I mean, you can, of course, you can say a LeBron story. You can, but I think the most impressive thing was how the organization was ran. You really couldn't. We all knew who the owners and the man was, but from the top all the way down to the bottom, everybody got treated the same, with the same amount of respect, the same amount of love. It was like, yeah, you got LeBron, yeah, you got the GM. No disrespect to the like a janitor or whatever they were their position. What, man, janitor, what's up? It was all love. What it was just.
What's happening?
Man,
okay.
It's like, man. Cause I know how I am. Like I'm a low key. I'm not no egotistic type of guy.
You grounded. Like you say, you grounded. You could be, but so, you grounded. Like I said, it's respect.
So when I'm gonna be nice to everybody regardless.
I don't know about South Carolina.
But when I see somebody else being the same,
say what, Waldo?
I said I don't know about South Carolina. That boy was famous in South Carolina.
Don't do me like that, man. But it was just. the love I would give, it was like somebody was giving more love than what I was giving. It was like a competition of giving love. So
favorite NBA city, traveler, just you know, on the road.
Was, I liked Toronto. Was amazing.
Yeah,
Lyra said
Toronto was amazing.
Okay,
it was
best city for nightlife. Now, sometimes you might do that. The two, because I know, like I heard coaches say, if you do Friday in Atlanta, or you might do Saturday shot. Like we do Atlanta, guys. We can't do both. Can't do Atlanta, Miami. We can't. Please don't schedule that for us, because that's asking a lot.
It's asking a whole lot.
When I was traveling with the Nuggets, man, they're doing too nice in L.A. We had to play the Lakers and the Clippers.
Now, see, the NBA, that's kind of like, and then what they'll do, I've noticed that they'll let you play, like, Friday night, you'll play the Clippers. Then you come back Sunday night and catch the Lakers.
You ain't going to be
you're on the West Coast.
If you go on a West Coast trip from the East Coast, they'll try to do it, or they'll do it to where you playing the Clippers one night, and then you'll fly, like, to Portland.
Okay.
And then come right back to L.A.
Okay. Boring NBA city.
That's easy.
Cleveland.
It was born in LA. Facts. It was Utah, though. Utah was terrible.
Utah was terrible.
Really? Okay. Utah most definitely.
Okay.
Milwaukee was
slow. Like,
yeah, I mean.
You really kick it. Okay. Really doing the thing. Let me ask you this. Anybody you played, and I mean, you a fan, you know, before you even got to the league, anybody you got to the court and like, man, I'm out here on the floor with this dude. I can't. Like, this is amazing. Because I know we all had that in us. I know you got that dog in you, but, like, was there anybody you was like, you know, like, man,
all
okay.
Of them.
All of them.
All of them.
Okay.
I ain't even going to lie to you, bro. Like, every life, it was dream come true. And I had already been watching all of them. Like, I was playing with Eddie Jones, Damon Stoudemire. Yeah. Like, man, I looked up to them dude, Chucky Atkins.
Chucky, you know what I'm saying?
So, right. It was, and then you get to play against the Kobe's. You get to play with LeBron or play against them. Or it was just... It does something psychological. Like, man, these are that's them.
Yeah.
And then you're like, I ain't gonna lie to you. Lean up, like, let me touch him. You know what I'm saying? Bump to him, like, man, that's him right there.
Because AI gave a Michael Jordan story, like when he first played against her, and it was like he just like he was stuck. Like you the first pick of the draft, franchise changing player, and he said when he got there played against Mike, he was like a kid. Like he just like. Man, I'm
Jordan
out
Jordan zone.
Yeah,
he got on Jordan.
He got on Jordan, and he had on Jordan. Like, he just, like he just this, floated. You know what I'm saying? So he just floated.
That's what it was, I guess. That's what it was with Kobe. It is what it is. I think everybody got that story with him, but that's what it was with Kobe. It was just like, man.
I'm out here with Kobe Bryant.
You freaking kidding me, God? Like, yeah. Thank you, bro. Like,
I'm out here with Kobe Bryant.
Like, for real.
Let me ask you
Went at him too. I ain't even gonna lie to you.
This way it's gonna be funny. What teammate that you know like the party? Like, and we just, I ain't talking about just, okay, man, you know I what? I can come. No, we're not putting them out. Okay. Like, okay, we're gonna have a good time. We traveling. I know, I can kick it with him. Kind of like how Waldo said y'all was at 5 points.
It was, I can't do it to him.
Okay.
I can't do it to him, but all my vets.
Your vets?
All my vets were,
okay.
They were just.
Oh, yeah. I already kind of figured that, though, yeah.
Nah, I mean, you know what, dog? Shout out to Eddie J.
Eddie Jones? That's for a lot of them.
Eddie Jones.
More than Timber, yeah.
We'll keep it 1,000. Eddie Jones was probably the smoothest dude I met. At that time in my life, like that man, bro was just smooth. Had it. I don't know what it's got going on family wise, but just a smooth individual.
Good
man.
Dude,
smooth, bro.
He a coach now?
Yeah.
For who?
I forgot.
Smooth, man.
Okay.
I'm talking about. When we get off of this, I'll tell you.
Let me ask you, the best city for food. Yeah. Who had the best food?
Louisiana, New Orleans, Memphis was good. New Orleans just be going crazy.
Yeah.
Craig get whole lot of food.
Red beans and rice, the jambalaya, the gumbo.
You crawfish?
I do.
Okay. I do. Okay. I always like to say, because I know Memphis got good barbecue.
Memphis.
You know what I'm saying? Did you ever go see A-Ball MJG while you was up there?
I had to.
Okay.
Seen them, Gotti, all them.
Okay. I
had to.
Best rap show you ever been to?
Best rap show.
rap concert. Cause I'm going to see Goody in a couple of weeks. So I can't wait for that.
I miss a lot. I ain't gonna lie to you.
You miss a lot.
I miss a lot of that stuff.
Okay.
I can't even really pinpoint one because I really. It really wasn't no concert situation. You know, like, they'd be in the club rapping.
Okay, club.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, we got a rapper in here, like, perform. He's gonna perform tonight.
Okay.
But he's in the club. So, it really wasn't nothing. He just said his song and got on.
And dipped.
You know what I mean?
Okay, that's respect. That's fair. Want to ask you one last question. What you call it? No, just to get a young kids that's listening some advice on their path, you know, and what can they do to achieve the dream of whatever it is they seek to do.
Lord, help me give them a good message. I would say the distance between your vision and manifesting it is nothing but attitude. Meaning, it's nothing but attitude. Once you wake up from that dream of what God showed you to end of your manifestation, the only way you're going to get there is it's that middle part. It's about your attitude, like being consistent, being persistent, not giving up. I mean, sometimes, like, you might go through the biggest storm in the world. It might make you want to run from you actually accomplishing your dream. But if you can actually stick with it with a good attitude, it ain't nothing really going to pretty much stop you. Because most people forfeit their dreams because of their attitude. They feel like, you know what, it's too far-fetched. And that they get it to that point of where they are at that moment, and they give up on it. Just never give up on your dream and keep a good attitude, a dog window. Meaning, I'm going to go get this every morning, be like, man, as soon as the sun come up, just be on it. Just be on it.
Okay. Good stuff. Any shout-outs y'all want to give before we get out of here, man? Like I said, tonight was... Serge, I thank you for letting us go over
no doubt.
Standard, but like this was long. This is well.
And I appreciate the enlightenment as to what isn't going on.
Yeah.
In this facts. Great city. I'm extremely irritated, but I appreciate it. And I apologize for not being more informed about that to the young people out there.
Hey, well, like,
we will address it. Yeah,
but like,
it will get addressed.
This old soul train, we want to bring y'all back, man. We got to get y'all back on the show. I'm telling you, this is good.
David Ruffin,
say what, Dave City?
David Ruffin, attorney in law. We're going to get it taken care of.
Yeah.
Oh, no. It's going to get addressed.
Let me know again about the 22nd. Let everybody know out there, man.
October 22nd at 9 a.m. at Jefferson High School. We have a Hillsborough County Coaches Clinic. The second part from 2 to 4:30 will be student athletes and parents, where we're just going to keep it real with them and let them know the expectations of being a student athlete and how to turn pro. And I also would like to give a shout out to my high school coaches. My high school teammates, each and last one of them, and everyone I competed against. Right now, every word that come out of my mouth, I'm going to try to be an advocate for y'all, because I know for a fact, when we spoke on Barry with OJ, and even my point guard, Kevin Vincent, I think he went to Manatee. They were, you know, those are good universities, but they were better players than that. And exactly. That comes just for the lack of exposure that our county is getting. Yeah. And I want to shout out my mom and my grandparents, because they definitely help push and motivate me every day. And also just the local support. And
well, Chop Shop behind you, man. Like I said, we definitely we're going to get some stuff going. Let me tell you what y'all got going.
Naturally.
Jefferson plug, okay.
Naturally.
Shout out to Jefferson University.
Yeah. People talking about around here, man.
So with that being said, man, for my man Tay, Green Bay 3-1 right now, so I know he feeling good. And y'all got the early game Sunday. Y'all got the Giants on Sunday.
Look at them, bro.
Get their doors blown by the Giants.
Daniel Jones.
4-1.
4-1, okay. Just play who in front of you. That's all you can do. All you can do. So, Waldo, you talked to Tom today?
Yeah. Tom said he's straight. He said Tom LDB. Said he's straight? Tom text me FDB. I don't know what that means. Tom text me FDB. I don't know what that means, bro.
You know what
that
means?
That's what he texted me. He said FDB.
So he clear that and he straight.
All right,
man.
I was in a promising mid.
Okay. So with that being said, man, for my man Ruff, Dane City's finest, Walt Bizzle, My man, Tate, TK, kicking it with us. And like I always say before we get out of here, man, anybody want to be an artist, don't want to see the exec produce all the videos, all the record, dancing, come to Death Row, man. But with that being said, shout out to my uncle, man, Michael Johnson, turned 70, man. Love your uncle. Good kicking it with you this past Sunday, man. So, hey, we back at it next Tuesday, man. Hey, keep God first. Love your family when you still holler. We gone. Good night. Get us out of here, sir.
A million,